Hi guys, welcome back. Today we're going to review Season 1's Episode 7 of Monarch Legacy of Monsters, which has been titled, Will the Real May Please Stand Up? This episode was mostly focused on May, or at least that is how we know her till now. The Rhonda siblings are also seen getting angry on Tim when he arrives all dehydrated at the airport, as Kate thinks that they abducted May, but then he tells them how she had the fake passports and her real name is Kara. Meanwhile, she is seen being taken in a private jet and it turns out she was a coder as we know her, but she had joined the AET, Applied Experimental Technologies. Now she wanted to help people walk, but after 2 years of her working at the company, she never saw anything being put to good use related to her work. And when she actually hacked into some encryptions to get the codes, and when she checked onto them, all she saw were chimpanzees and their heads open wired with tech. So they were experimenting on animals, and so she deleted all the research and ran away, and she did exactly right. Shaw, on the other hand, is seen hijacking Outpost 88, which is in Alaska. Tim and the Rhonda siblings are also seen visiting Cora's house, where her sister, who is actually named May, tells them everything. And when they find May, aka Cora, she tells them to just leave her alone, as her boss wanted her to spy and report everything about the Titans if she left. But then Natalie is seen making some calls, and Cora is actually free now. Tim also convinces Natalie to take Monarch public for the very first time. So for the first time in decades, they did something right. An Easter egg is also hinted, as we can literally see Apex on Korra's boss's screen. And now Kintaro, Kate and Cora, aka May, have resumed their mission to find Shaw and what he is doing while teaming up with Monarch. We also saw Shaw doing a really crazy thing where he plants bombs around the energy signature where the lights were seen in Alaska. It's like a wormhole, I think, and he blows it in such a way that it intertwines in itself and collapses. I really think that it has something to do with his age, as he is definitely not 90. So guys, stay tuned for further more updates, and if you guys enjoyed, please like, comment, share, and subscribe if you haven't. Thank you.